I spoke to the Shadow Minister for Families and Social Services, Linda Burney, about the disparity.
There is a huge difference between the number of people who are unemployed and the number of jobs available between the city and particularly regional areas. In the city, and these are averages, there are about 12 people on JobSeeker looking to get one position available. But when you get to regional areas, and on average, there are 28 people on JobSeeker and one job available. And this makes it extremely difficult for people living in regional Australia.
What could you put this down to, do you think?
I think that there has been a real downturn in many of the industries in regional Australia. I think the fact that there are more people on JobSeeker indicates that. I mean, I dispel absolutely this notion that somehow or other the coronavirus supplement that comes with JobSeeker at the moment is discouraging people from applying for jobs. That's just untrue, despite what the government is saying. But we do know that there is disparity across the country as well. In different regions, it is worse than other regions, for example.
Ms. Burney, the JobSeeker payment and its reaction by those that have gone on to this JobSeeker payment or were on its existing payments that were, of course, called an entirely different name, we have heard mixed reactions, to put it plainly. People have been praising this payment. People have also been criticising this payment. We've heard a number of reports as well that this amount of money has improved people's quality of life. People have been able to put food on the table, so on and so forth. What's your reaction to this?
I suspect people who are criticising the amount have never had to live on the amount. Living on $40 a day on the old New State amount was an actual disincentive for people to go out and find work. They just could not afford to pay bus fares, to actually get something to wear, to go to a job interview. It also meant that they were making choices between things like medicine and food, children having shoes to go to school with, and going without food themselves, and that was the reality of people's lives. With the coronavirus supplement, the JobSeeker, with the old New Start, was turned into a thing called JobSeeker, and there was an extra $500 a fortnight supplement. That will drop back to $250 a fortnight supplement at the end of this month. And then there is absolutely nothing from the government about what happens to people on JobSeeker after the 30th of December. And I think that's cruel and inappropriate.
So the statistics read that there are 42 job seekers for one job vacancy in regional South Australia. We just spoke of the reasoning behind that or what that could mean or why that is the case in regional South Australia. As I understand it, JobSeeker is just that. You have to apply for a number of jobs to be able to receive the supplement.
Yes, that's absolutely right. And I'm really glad you raised that. There is absolutely the prospect or the reality that there is a mutual obligation for people receiving JobSeeker, and that is that you are offered a job and it's reasonable for you to be able to take it, then you're required to take it. You also have to apply for, I think it's 4 jobs a month at the moment while the virus is in place. And I have to say that I think that people who are offered a job and it's reasonable that they have a real obligation to take that job.
So what are you calling on from the government?
What I'm calling on from the government is that they need to announce a permanent increase to JobSeeker. Everyone from Access Economics right through argues that this is important. It's important to people who find themselves on JobSeeker. But it's also really important because people who are living on small amounts of money, like people on JobSeeker, spend all their money, all their reserve cash in the economy, and therefore small businesses and jobs are protected.
There is obviously the cashless debit card scheme. It has been trialled in our area here in South Australia. There has been data that has shown that once the JobSeeker payments have begun, they've been, well, I guess there's been more disposable income. It has been reported that people have been using this income for retail in an overwhelming sense. Do you think that, this statistic reflects exactly where this extra money could go?
Well, I think it's very important, and you might have, some people might have heard Paul Zara at the press club yesterday, that injections of money into the retail sector is really a very important way for the economy to bounce back from this recession. And people are using it to pay bills, to pay rent, to buy food and to buy clothes, and I think that's very important.
Shadow Minister for Families and Social Services, Linda Burney there.